Do you encounter this error when you try to force a text to become a dead field in Data Studio? If yes, you are on the same boat now. In this tutorial, I will bring you through steps by steps on how I resolve a dead time formatting issue that I faced. Well, if you read this note over here, Data Studio actually treat us quite well that they actually gives us some possible solutions. The first solution is to change your data to use a supported format. I find it a bit funny that Data Studio doesn't tell us what kind of format it is supporting. Or am I missing something here? So in summary, I can't use this method because I got this data set from Kaggle. You can probably try this method out if you can use any method to change your format in SQL statement before you load the data into Data Studio. Okay, so now we can only go for a second option, which is to create a calculated field to convert invoice date, which is the date column, to a valid date. And here is an example by using a parse date. But before I go into that, I just want to show you a bit on how messy the data is. So if you look at the invoice date, you can see that the format of the value here is not consistent. Some of it has the seconds, some of it doesn't have. So in this case, if you just apply the parse date formula, it wouldn't work. What I did is to make the date format consistent, then only we parse the text to become a date. This shows the steps. First, I tried to format it straight using parse date, and then I found that it doesn't work because the parse date formula won't work if the format here is not consistent. Then I tried to extract the date from invoice date time. From here, I parse the date to become a valid date. So if you are interested on how I do that and what are the formulas involved, keep watching. So first of all, let me show you the first step to extract the date. So here we are using a formula called reject, stands for regular expression extract. So this formula allows us to extract part of the text using regular expressions. In case you are not familiar with these terms, regular expressions are patterns that are used to match character combinations in text. But don't worry, just follow me. In the formula, indicate the text field that you want to extract the date from. Now the second parameter is the pattern. So I have actually recorded a video on how to construct this simple pattern, but I've lost that footage, unfortunately. So for now, I'll just put the link to the rejects document so you can refer it. Now we have all the dates extracted in similar format. Then we can now proceed to parse the date. To parse the date, we will need to follow the table reference. Well, it can be quite confusing if someone throws you this table and asks you to figure it out, right? Don't worry, I won't do that to you. To be honest, I'm also not super good at this, but I'm just trying my best to tell you what I have learned and hopefully you will find this useful. To start with this, I will recommend you to take a look at the examples over here. If let's say you spot an example that it looks exactly like how your data looks like, then you can straight away use the reference over here. But if you are like me, you can't find the match format, then you have to construct one. I'll go to my iPad to demonstrate this. Okay, so first of all, I need to get the extracted date format. So we have this format. This is the month, followed by the day, followed by year. So now we need to go to the reference table and look for the day of the month as a decimal number. This looks like what is matched. So here we can just write down what is the reference that we just found earlier in that table. The next one, I'm going to get the month. So this one, the month as a decimal number. Just be careful when you look at this reference table. Do take note that this is case sensitive. Like, if it's a capital M, it means minute. If it's a small letter M, it's month. And then I'm going to look for year. So there's 2-year format. One is with century, one is without. So my one is the one with century, which is 4-digit. So I'm going to take this capital Y. Now, after you have constructed this, the last step is actually to take this symbol over here and fill in here. So if your date format is in this format, then what you should be doing is using this. If yours is in dot, then you can change it to dot. So now we have got our format string to be put into the formula parsedate. Then for the second parameter, we are going to use extracted date, which we have extracted from invoice date using the formula rejects. And you will see the format is in a date format. If you notice, you will see that parsedate actually has a date icon in front of the dimension. That means that we have successfully converted it from a string, which is the invoice date, to a date format recognized by Data Studio. The advantage of having it in a write date format is that now we're able to sort this table based on the date field. Firstly, when we are using a string to sort this table, you can see that it's not in the right order. So now we can change this up with the new field that we just created. Yep, it's now sorted accordingly. So I think that's all for today. If you're interested to check out how we can reformat this date to our desired format, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you will get notified next time. I hope you find the tutorial useful.